Now we're noticing that as the number of minutes increases, the average, so in this case we're looking at the average really, that's what A represents. It's in, the outputs are in dollars per minute. And so we noticed that, at least we noticed for from 0 to 10, the price increased from 7 cents to about 9 cents per minute. And then we have this asymptote over at 0.4. So up here is 0.4 somewhere, and we have this horizontal asymptote. So as the number of minutes increases, it must be approaching that asymptote, roughly like this. And we're going to graph it to see. And then our vertical asymptote is somewhere over here at negative 10. So basically, if you continued to sketch it, it would look pretty much, be shaped pretty much like all the other ones we've looked at, except we're looking at the graph below the vertical asymptote. Why are we doing that? Well, because whenever you're talking about zero, or when you're talking about a positive number of minutes, it seems that the output values were all below that asymptote. So 0.07, that's for 0 minutes. That's your vertical intercept. 9 cents a minute, that's 100 minutes later. Or if you've used 100 minutes, not 10 minutes, so this would be 100. But as you continue to use more and more minutes, your average price is actually going up. Well, that must be because of the fact that whenever you use just your plan, $59.99 divided by 900 minutes only comes out to 7 cents per minute. But now you're incurring 40 cent additions for every additional minute you add as overage, and so naturally your average is going to go up. It's going to approach 40 cents per minute because this term will dominate. If you use 1,000 overage minutes, then these two numbers really don't make that much of a difference. They start to become a smaller part of the equation, and so we start to notice something that looks like this. Now we could graph this in our graphing calculator. I'm going to do this in a website that's called wolframalpha.com, and so what I will do is I will just enter in parentheses these two equations. So I'll do 59.99 plus 0.4m, and then I'll divide that by 900 plus m. So there is my equation, and I will just hit enter and just see what Wolfram Alpha produces. This is a really powerful engine that will show us things graphically, and it shows us one graph, but we're not really satisfied with that. So let's do this. Let's say at the very beginning of this, I'm going to write plot. And I want to plot this function from m equals 0 to m equals, let's say theoretically 10,000 overage minutes. Now that would mean you probably are talking too much, but let's just take a look at what this would indicate. And there it is. So we can see that as we use a few number of minutes, our average price is really low, but as you use more and more overage minutes, your average is getting closer to that overage charge. On average. And so that's kind of what we see here. And so our asymptote is right above here, and our vertical asymptote is back here, kind of the way we sketched it.